Hello friends, good evening again. In this session, we will talk about DNA repair mechanism. So first of all, we have several repair mechanisms. Direct reversal repair mechanism. One group is the single strand damage repair mechanism. One is the double strand breaks repair mechanism. One is translesion synthesis DNA repair mechanism. One is SOS repair mechanism. It also can be pronounced as the save our soul repair mechanism. It is found in prokaryotes only. In the direct reversal repair mechanism, there are two mechanisms are there. Photoreactivation mechanism is included, and another is the direct repair. In the single strand damage repair mechanism, we have again two, excision repair mechanism, as well as we have the mismatch repair mechanism. In the case of the excision repair mechanism, we have again the two excision repair mechanism. So again, it can be classified into two. Just suppose here single strand damage repair, it have been classified into two mechanisms. One is the mismatch repair and one is the excision repair. So again, this excision repair can be classified into two: base excision repair mechanism and another is the nucleotide excision repair mechanism. Here in the double strand breaks repair mechanism, we have recombination repair mechanism. In the recombination repair mechanism, again we have two type of recombination repair mechanism. One is the homologous recombination repair and second one is the non-homologous end joining repair mechanism. So in detail, we will talk about the every repair mechanism that is found in the eukaryotes as well as in the prokaryotic organisms. First question is that why we need to repair this DNA? Because if unwanted change, that is known as the mutation, is found in the DNA, then this DNA will not make the proper protein. In the direction of the DNA, whatever proteins are going to be made, they will not be formed properly. So some mistakes, several default or several exchange mismatch that found in the DNA, then this will again found in the RNA and protein also. So if this DNA, if these mutations in the DNA are get repaired, then we are sure about there will be the proper protein and our body will function properly. Two chances are there. If DNA is not repaired, then mutation is permanently. If permanent mutation is there, then evolution will be there. But sometime, as per the natural selection, some individuals get die and they lost. So mutations is beneficial as well as it is harmful. If mutation is there, then there are two probability: either evolution will be there and either individual will be lost. So for the living things, if organism want to sustain, then one stable copy of the DNA must be there. So to make the stable copy of the DNA, we have to repair the DNA. We have to repair DNA because during the replication process, several mistakes are there. Even in the replication, these mutations are get repaired, and this repairing after the replication, these are known as the post replication repair mechanism. So after the replication process, this system will start to function. So if this is not repaired, then obviously stable copy of DNA will not be passed on to the offsprings, and as a result they will lack the stable copy, and mutations can arise evolution, as well as it can also arise the newer variety, newer type of the species, newer type of the strain, and the old or the offspring strain also can be lost. So first thing that we are going to learn is direct reversal, direct repair mechanism. It is known as the direct reversal, direct reversal. So we have to focus there. If DNA is here, now this DNA is going to be replicated, another copy of the DNA is formed. Here we found the one mistake over here, so this mistake can be repaired by direct reversal mechanism. Here this nucleotide will be break or removed, so this nucleotide will be get removed and newer nucleotide will be joined here. One problem that is found due to the mutation is the xeroderma pigmentation, xeroderma pigmentosum. So in this case, what is going to be happen due to the UV light, due to the UV light that is generally present in the sunlight, in our body there is one mechanism of formation of melanin. We have the one pigment named melanin. This melanin have the ability to absorb the ultraviolet radiation, but if the skin lacks this melanin pigment, then this ultraviolet radiation can penetrate even into the skin. Okay? And if this ultraviolet radiation reach to the DNA, then this ultraviolet radiation have the higher energy, and if this ultraviolet radiation that containing higher energy reach to the DNA, they will mutate the DNA. They also can break the DNA, but here they can mutate this DNA, and as a result of the mutation, as this mutation will cause this disease, xeroderma pigmentosum. Generally this ultraviolet radiation mutation can be repaired by the photoreactivation mechanism. But here in the patient of the xeroderma pigmentosum, the photoreactivation speed is lower speed of the repair mechanism. So repair mechanism is have lower speed than the mutation. Okay, so mutation is faster than the repair mechanism. So here xeroderma pigmentosum is found. In this case generally sunburn is found, okay. Now we will look at the photoreactivation mechanism. In the case of the photoreactivation, generally we have to learn first what is DNA damage. So specifically here what is going to happen, ultraviolet radiation have the higher energy, so it will make the pyrimidine dimers, generally thymine dimers are get formed. So generally bond pairing between the thymine is not found in the DNA, but as in the one strand, if two thymines are present, then this thymine will make the bonds between each other. So on the correspondent end there will be adenine, so this adenine have get changed the structure. So now the structure of the DNA is changed, as a result transcription is blocked, and so proteins could not be formed, and this DNA damage can be repaired by the photoreactivation mechanism. So here what first pyrimidine dimer is, so here in this figure we can see the pyrimidine dimers. Here, two thymine are there in the one strain. This thymine is getting paired with the another thymine. As a result, one kink is formed. One kink is formed. As this kink is formed, this DNA molecule could not be replicated. It could not be replicated and it could not also be transcripted properly. And as a result, sunburns generally form. And now, this is due to the ultraviolet light. And now, how to repair it? For the repair mechanism, just suppose here thymine dimer is get formed. It is also known as the pyrimidine dimers. One enzyme is there. Name of that enzyme is the photolyse. So photolyse enzyme have the ability to break this thymine dimer in the presence of visible light only. Okay. So we can say that, we can conclude that whatever the damage that is caused by the ultraviolet radiation in the presence that is present in the sunlight, it even repaired in the sunlight only. It can even repair in the sunlight only. So if organisms that are already mutated by the ultraviolet light and thymine dimers are get formed, then it can be easily repaired in the visible light. Okay? And so this is the reason why all the organisms are not killed that are present in environment. Just suppose we think that bacteria is over here. If ultraviolet radiation is penetrating inside the cell and if the DNA is get mutated, then obviously this bacteria must be killed. But this bacteria have the photolyse enzyme again, and visible light, in the presence of visible light, this photolyse enzyme will repair this DNA damage. So thymine dimer will be break, and as a normal thymines will be found here. So cyclobutane dimers are get cleaved by this enzyme, and at finally DNA is get repaired. This photolyse enzyme now get released. Here we have to remember only that in the presence of visible light only, this photoreactivation repair mechanism can be function. Now we have the another type of the repair mechanism that is also known as the direct reversal mechanism. That is also known as the direct reversal mechanism. Here what is going to be happen is that generally instead of the guanine here methyl guanine nucleotide is attached. So on the sixth number of the carbon, one extra methyl group is there. So it is necessary to remove this methyl group. For that purpose, one enzyme methyl transferase is there. So this methyl transferase enzyme have the cysteine. Okay. Generally, enzymes are the sequence of the amino acids. So this cysteine will make the bond with the methyl group, and methyl group is removed by this enzyme. Now this active enzyme is converted into the inactive enzyme, and this methyl guanine nucleotide is converted into just a guanine nucleotide. Here we can see cysteine is here. The cysteine is get bind with the methyl group, and this methyl guanine is converted into just a guanine. So this was all about the direct repair mechanism. This was all about the direct repair mechanism. After the direct repair mechanism, we have the excision repair. In the case of the excision repair mechanism, one nucleotide or the stretch of the nucleotides are get removed, and as this nucleotide stands are get removed, then after this nucleotides again resynthesize. So then after replication process, then after replication process is applied again in the same way. Okay? So as replication process is applied, due to the replication mechanism, whatever strands are get removed, they are again repaired. They are again get repaired. So why we are going to remove that strand? Because they are generally mutated. So here in this figure you can see one damaged base is here, one damaged base is here. Now this damaged base can be removed. Okay, we know that there is the difference between the base and the nucleotide. Okay, so there are two type of excision mechanism: base excision repair and another is the nucleotide excision repair. So one can be termed as the NER, another is the BER, nucleotide excision repair mechanism and base excision repair mechanism. So what is going to happen is this damaged base will be removed by the DNA glycosylase enzyme. This will be removed by the DNA glycosylase enzyme. Now this site that have not the presence of base is known as the AP site. It is known as the AP site. Now one enzyme that is integrated in this mechanism is the AP endonuclease enzyme. So this enzyme will remove the correspondent nucleotides. So this all nucleotides are get removed. Okay. So we can say that the phosphodiester bond, that is present is get break. So all the phosphodiester bonds are get break, and this all the nucleotides around this mutations are get removed. Now again DNA polymerase enzyme 1 will resynthesize. That will resynthesize from this direction, because here 5 prime end is there, here 3 prime end is there, so 3 prime OH will be found. So here new nucleotides will be added. So here 3 all nucleotides are get added. Here one nick will still remain, because this nucleotide have just only one phosphorus. This nucleotide have just only one phosphorus, and normally nucleotides have the three phosphorus. Normally nucleotide that is still have to bind with the sugar here is the structure of the nucleotide. It have the three nucleotides, so it can be said that DNTP is triphosphate. There are three phosphorus are present. So as this nucleotide will be joined with this 3 prime, so 2 phosphorus mean the pyrophosphorus will be removed and energy is released. As a result, energy is released. But here this phosphorus could not be removed because only one phosphorus is remained, and this phosphorus cannot be removed. So here energy from the ATP is used. And here another polymerase enzyme is used, and that is known as the DNA ligase. So here DNA ligase enzyme will seal this nick with the use of the ATP. And in this way, this excision repair mechanism function. So I hope you have get this point properly. If you have any question, then you may ask.